Here we are at Real to talk to you about the North Charge. So North Charge is their new performance wave kite surfing board. This board is a really, really good production kite surf board. I have not ridden a production kite surf board that I've liked in kind of ever. And this board I like a lot, and I'll be riding this board a lot. They came up with a construction, a design, like, you know, it kind of was like, how did this awesome kiteboarding construction and kite surf board construction and stuff come out of space? Like, why has nobody done this before? They're using a really, really high-end tech and really high-end blanks and everything like that to make an excellent kite surf board. So to understand this board, first gonna start on the bottom. And it's a EPS epoxy blank. You're gonna see this black line that goes here and goes all the way down around the bottom, goes around the fin box, through that fin box, and all the way around. So this is a carbon Integra weave. And so this is basically gonna give you some strength, and it's gonna tie the fin boxes right into the blank. So this goes right, wraps around the fin boxes, goes all the way through here. And so it basically makes the, you know, everything feel super connected. You can also see it's coming right down through the center here. So they're using this as their stringer to make this board be a lightweight epoxy board, but still have strength, right? So the problem with production boards is most of the times, until this one, is that they are super stiff and feel like a total brick, or they're super fragile and they're gonna break or snap or whatever. I don't really do big airs or anything like that, so I don't really break boards, but I hate those like super stiff, bricky production boards because they just have no flex and they're just bouncy and they just don't really ride that well. And then, so I'm normally riding customs, and you know, customs wear out over time. They wear out and, you know, they'll kind of dent out or just kind of get all soft and mushy. Whereas this thing, I haven't ridden it for a long time because it hasn't been out a long time, but I bet it will kind of have a really good positive feel for quite some time. So the construction of the board is awesome. Getting into the sizes, this is the 5.7. I'm normally riding like a 5.8 or 5.9 for my kite surf boards. This is a 5.7. This is definitely the right size board for me. They have 5.7, 5.9, and 5.11. So like I'm 165 pounds. You know, and it's just a great all-around kite surf board for me. So looking at this board, it's a pretty straightforward shape, right? So like the shape of these boards, you know, like performance, high performance surfboards, the shape's been around for a little while and they're not really changing them a ton or that much. Whereas this board is like got a lot of like cool designs, kind of single concave is kind of the what they're doing in high performance shortboards, coming out kind of flat off the tail, nice and thin tail through here. And also the rails are really tapered down. So it just kind of motors through chop. It just motors through chop, but then when you're on a wave, it releases really well, the tail releases really well, and it's just kind of good all around feel to it. They did use FCS2 fin boxes, which is great because those are snap-in fins, they just pop in really easily. They included a set of stock fins with them. These fins are what I consider a good set of backup fins. These are the classic double tab FCS fins. So it's nice that they ship this board with fins, but I don't really like these fins that much. One, they're size large, which is kind of too big for me. I'm normally surfing a medium size fin. Two, they got the FCS2 boxes, but with this, you have to use a compatibility kit, which has a spacer and the two little inserts in there, you know, which I really don't, you know, which is fine for stock setup, but I'm personally riding this board with, you know, my own set of fins. I really like the Mick Fanning fins, and also like the FCS2 Julian Wilson fins work really well for this board specifically. So, you know, and the reason they did that, the reason that they had the, you know, included with stock fins is to go to an actual set of FCS2 fins would have increased the board price by $200, which they wanted. They had a price level they were trying to keep it at, and the fact that they hit the price level they did and included a you know, not a cheap set of plastic crappy fins, but actually honeycomb fins, was pretty impressive. So good backup fins. I'll take them with me on a trip, but I'm gonna bring my other fins that I like, you know, that I'm comfortable with and know. So the other tech about this board, full EVA deck pad. You can see that it's kind of dimpled back here and ridged up here. Really nice kicktail. They also put it in the right spot. Anytime I see You know, EVA pads on a board already. I'm like, oh, they're gonna have the kicktails gonna be too far forward. You want to basically get the kicktail all the way back right to the leash line, because you want to have your foot right back over that back fin so you can really push super hard on it. When you're going upwind, your back foot's gonna be forward, and then when you're on that wave, you want to have it right against that kicktail so you can really hammer on it. It has a ton of excellent grip here, and then going up here to this part of the pad, it's really, really quite comfortable. This little ridge, I kind of thought it was like hokey. Like, again, I don't do airs. I don't need really kick thing. Until I had this thing, I kind of just like, I don't really need it. Tacking, jibing, my foot bumps up against this thing all the time, and it's great because it tells me where I am on the board. So I just have a good point of reference. You can see right here, in here you've got insert setups, so that you can ride this board strapped, which is actually pretty impressive that they made this board strong enough to ride straps. I do not recommend jumping any kitesurf board. I don't know what Norse ruling is on it, but if you jump a kitesurf board, that's going to be probably the fastest way to break it. If you jump a kitesurf board with foot straps on it, you're probably definitely going to break it. I mean, this thing feels really strong and solid, but just a precursor out there, if you're jumping this with foot straps on, there's a good chance that you could put, you know, your foot through the board. So one of the really unique things about this board that you cannot see is underneath this deck pad right here, they've got two EVA inserts laminated into the board. So underneath the glass, you've got these EVA inserts, and you can feel under here, is, you know, you can't feel it, but I can feel it, that it's real soft and kind of under your foot, like you feel like it just has a lot of vibration absorption. And then you're up here, you can definitely, it's like, oh, okay, that's just EVA pad on board. But here you feel this like nice kind of dense foam underneath your foot, and it definitely makes a difference. You will get heel dents in here just like any other kitesurf board. I actually think that's a good thing because that's then your foot knows where to go without looking. But do know that this is kind of like a really premium construction, and anytime you're riding a premium construction kitesurf board, you will get heel dents under here. So kudos to North. Like, I can't believe that they made a actual kitesurf board that doesn't suck. Not only does it not suck, but it's freaking awesome, man. This board rides so well. I'm actually going to take another session on it right now, so we're gonna get this review done. So I gotta go take a session. If you want more reviews, go to realwatersports.com. You want to get one of these things? Give us a call to shop. 252-987-6000. See you guys on the water.